Motioncam RAW is now my default camera 99% of the time. It was already a very powerful tool at release, but initially that power came at the cost of speed. Editing RAW video is a time and resource consuming process, at least it used to be. My optimal workflow is rendering every RAW file into ProRes HQ with Cineon Log before chucking them into Premiere Pro. It still needs an ungodly amount of overhead storage, so I understand why for many people who rely on speed, this workflow is out of the question. Now, I don't want to understate how insane it is to have your phone shoot in RAW video, but like I said, that power comes at a cost. However, that cost just got way smaller. If we were to translate cost in terms of storage space, a 10-second full RAW video takes about 2 GB of storage, and a 10-second high bitrate 4K H.265 video is around 100 megabytes. That's a life-changing difference right there. And that's why Motioncam's latest Directlog update changes the game. Because you can now record directly from raw data to log video in real time. To put it simply, Motioncam can now shoot regular videos. This opens up massive opportunities to simplify your workflow. It increases the usability for phones that have lower storage space and opens up Motioncam to run and gun style videos. Not only that, you can also shoot in ProRes. Yep, that feature isn't exclusive to the iPhone anymore. Now, it's not perfect yet. I've been able to shoot in ProRes HQ at bin 1080p in Cineon Log with very stable frame rates, but I think it'll take a few more hardware generations or app updates before we can shoot ProRes in full 4K. Despite saying that, 1080p bin still gives me enough bitrate to color grade and post while preserving a lot of detail for upscaling. Another weird caveat is that if you're on a Snapdragon 888 or 8th Gen 1 device like me, you are going to be limited to 8-bit 420 in HEVC because apparently there's no 10-bit encoder on those chips. So if you need to shoot 10-bit, either shoot RAW or use ProRes. But still, in the bigger picture, these are minor inconveniences to what Motioncam has managed to achieve. With Directlog, the only reason you wouldn't use Motioncam is if you need high frame rates, or if your device doesn't support Motioncam at all, in which case, condolences. The good news is that more and more new devices are starting to support 60 frames per second on Motioncam. So, the future is looking very bright indeed. Also, I'd like to shout out a huge underrated feature that was eclipsed by Directlog. Motioncam had a huge breakthrough in its offline rendering speed, and when I say huge, I mean faster than real time. It's so fast, I usually prefer to skip Directlog for casual point and shoots. Unless you're doing a full day session, I'd rather record in RAW and fully render the video out with a LUT because it only takes a few seconds to render anyway. And that's all for me. So go, make videos.